When you configure a list of data favorites, that list is stored with the user profile. So you'll notice when you come back into the system, if you're logged in as a different user, you may see that data favorites list doesn't exist. So there are ways of sharing this across computers. The way you would do that is by exporting this and then importing it into another. So just by doing a right mouse click, I can choose Export Favorites. It's going to save it into a very specific format, a text file. Let me just go ahead and save this. If I go in and take a look at this format, as you can see, it's just saving two things. It's the name of the tag, including the server, along with the descriptor. And that's something that when you send that to somebody else or you put that on a server, you can have other people import that. And that way, everybody can have a shared data favorites. One other thing that's available is if you've got an application that supports drag and drop, like Excel or Word, you can drag and drop things into this data favorites from there. So for example, let's say you're looking at some kind of a shift report. Here's a shift report. And there's some, let's say there's some things on here that you'd like to bring into your data favorites. Just go ahead and select it and choose whatever drag and drop. There we go. Is appropriate for that particular, for that particular application. In this case, you have to grab just the bounding box there, drop it in there, and that now becomes a data favorite. It's not necessarily going to bring in the descriptor, but it still works as advertised. As you can see, I can still drag these over. And that's going to work whether you're using Excel or some other application that supports drag and drop. Like for example, over here, I've just done a traditional tag search. I did a tag search. We found these tags, pasted them into here. Absolutely no problem with me grabbing these, dragging these over. Now they become part of my data favorites. Or I could alternately take this and copy this over into a Word document. Now here it is in a Word document. I'll just select it the way I would normally select things in Word. Click, drag, and drop. Now that becomes part of data favorites, and now I can start, making use of these in my trends and my bar graphs, etc. So once I've created this again, I can export this, and now this now becomes my new data favorites. And of course, I can have multiple files if I want. Normally, as I said, it's the user profile that contains this. Now I'm going to go ahead and delete this and just demonstrate what happens with the import. I'll go ahead and import favorites. I'll find this my data favorites.txt. As you can see, this was originally what I had exported.